This edition of the Ridley Report is brought to you by
Free Talk Live Radio that puts you in control.
There are a few people who have signs who aren't with us.
Well, here's our issue. I've never seen a permit for a demonstrate. So, as far as I know, you can demonstrate as long as you don't have disorderly conduct and or you don't block the sidewalk.
There they are. Concord, New Hampshire police standing up for my human rights. Not much more than a year after a different set of Concord police did almost exactly the same thing in almost exactly the same spot.
Are you going to try and get me arrested for standing on the sidewalk?
Oh, you're one of those Ron Paul, everything first and fourth amendment. We're asking you politely, can you please?
When this guy reported them, reported me to them for standing on a sidewalk, they refused to assist him in removing me. So I've had some theories as to why I have relatively little trouble with police. This despite the very large amount of activism I do, which could be considered anti-establishment. In a previous video, I named four or five of the factors that I could think of off the top of my head. After completing the video, I thought up another four or five more. There's this thing they call the Mike Wallace phenomenon, although I probably shouldn't be comparing myself to Mike Wallace for very long. But they used to say that with Mike Wallace on 60 Minutes, the reason people would talk to him while he was investigating them was because he let them have their say. He wouldn't edit out that much of what they said. At least when you consider that he was probably limited to 10 minutes in package length. Oh, did I just say package length? That's how long his stories were allowed to be, is what I'm trying to say. You know, roughly 10 minutes, maybe up to 12. Well, I'm able to even improve on that, but since I don't have any limits at all in how long my packages can be. Each YouTube video is a package, and it's going to be probably 5 or 6 minutes, but I can go to one event and, shoot 60 minutes of video and come back and put all 60 minutes of it on the air, so to speak. 60 minutes. I can run 10 5-minute stories. I don't have to cut anything interesting out. If something's boring enough, I might have to cut it out. So probably people who watch the channel have this instinctive understanding that I'm really not editing out much of what they say. I have this, I guess, a policy or rule, you might call it, of I won't pull a Colbert, I guess, since everyone's now familiar with what Colbert does to people, since he did it to some Free Staters. The idea of doing a package about people and getting their cooperation and having them talk to you and then using their cooperation against them, right, to make fun of them. Well, I don't really do that, actually. I will make fun of people who try to stop me from filming or they're really rude to me. But if someone is just going to engage me on a matter of policy and debate with me, I can't imagine coming home and then editing the video to make them look bad, right? Their comments might make them look bad, but I can't imagine coming home and then editing video around to undermine what they were saying. So if I'm going to illustrate video, from an interview with a hostile, or at least, an opponent type person, then I won't stick in video that undermines what they're saying, right? It can only be illustrated video. That's almost like a rule. I guess I could break it at some point, but I don't think I ever have.
Free Talk Live.